morning, 9:24 Central Time. And we're getting ready to roll. We got out, we took the puppies out, let them do their thing. We did a VI. Something before I get on the actual road. I'm gonna see if they got a cat skill here. Thank you. loaded. We only had 3 hours left. And I got there at 3:30. Our appointment was at 4. They didn't get us loaded until about 10 o'clock last night. I kind of loved it when dispatch says, and it's not their fault. Again, I'm not saying it's their fault. They're only being told what they're being told by the shipper, right? But I get a phone call asking me what time I'm going to be there, and I said, well, I'm in line at the Blue Beacon. I got to get fuel yet, and I got to get the low locks. I had to get 3 of them low locks, because that's what was said to me. Make sure you get 3 low locks. First of all, they didn't even use the low locks. There's no room to use them. So they just set them on the floor. I got them though. I made sure I had them. I didn't want to leave them there with them. I just bought them, right? Cost me $112 to make sure I had them, but I didn't even need them. But make sure you get the 3 low locks, so I got them. And I said about what time I think I'm going to be there. I said if I left right now, I'd be there like at 12:57 or something like that. I said, but I got to 4 to get there. I said, yeah, but you know, it's a holiday week and they just want to make sure. Straight there without stopping, but I was getting hungry, so I got me something to eat. Got me some ribs and got me some whatever the other thing was. But and then I sat and I finally got out. Back up to the guard shack. I said, if I'm late delivering this load, I'm not going to get blamed for it. When are they going to load me? So he called over there at the shipping, and they told him, well, go ahead and have him come in the gate. I had to go weigh my empty, and then I had backed in the door 1. Finally got out of there at 10 o'clock. And I'm thinking to myself, there's no way I'm going to be able to get through Dallas, especially if it's messed up, before I run out of my 11, 14 hour day. So I stopped at that place and got me a good sleep. I did too. I slept good. with their headlights on. Folks. freezing. Just wet roads. Could be a whole different story as we're going north. But I don't know how far this rain is going. So far, I've been fairly lucky about running into snow or ice. think that's the channel. It was on 8:20 a.m. If I was down in Cincinnati area, it was Truck and Bozo, WLW, 700 WLW. That was Truck and Bozo out of Cincinnati. And if I was down south New Orleans area, that would be the that would be Dave Nemo and Charlie Douglas. And if I was in the Fort Worth area, Texas area, or out west a little bit, 8:20 a.m., Bill Mack, the Midnight Cowboy. Then when Bill Mack got on satellite radio, he was the satellite cowboy satellite Bill Mack. Truck and Bozo has always been Truck and Bozo. Even when he actually went to XM radio. I think Dave Nemo's still around. He's on XM radio as well. I do believe he's still alive. But if I came through here and it was midnight, I guaranteed I'd listen to Bill Mack. Yep. The Midnight Cowboy. With his wife, Sweet Cindy. I have to be going back to a few years for some of you guys to remember that. And that actually shows how long I've been driving. That's long before satellite radio came in. That's when you had to chase down the AM dial. Controversy thing, Worth than it would have been going through Dallas. In my opinion, I mean, we had a few slowdowns, but we didn't have nothing. Absolutely nothing like we had that morning I came through Dallas. That was a straight up honest to God nightmare. And I didn't show you guys everything on that. I mean, not everything. That was just chaos.
boy.
Waco. Waco, Texas. Drove through Fort Worth, all the way into Oklahoma, through Kansas. Now we're in Nebraska. I have 37 miles to my delivery. I'm gonna try my best to see if I can get this off tonight, though. I'm gonna try. Beatrice, rice, beet, I don't know how you